very happy, very focused, very at peace with himself right now.
How hard is it, though, to come back to the same world that pushed you into the depths of darkness to start with?
Yeah. The world doesn't push you into the depths of darkness. You do. And it drives me nuts because the week before WrestleMania, there's a big article in USA Today talking about Dale Wilkes, the Patriot. Raven was in there. Someone else was in there talking about Louis Spicoli and all the pills. Ravens, you know, 200 pills a day habit. And you know, 200 pills a day. I had neck surgery, all right? I'm laying in the hospital the day after, and I'm taking no more than 4 pain pills a day. 200 pills a day? No, it's a little extreme, okay? And they blame it on the industry? No, it's your choice, all right? I've been doing this 18 years. I do it now. I do it every week. You know, I think I got a pretty good grasp, and I think I'm not an outsider looking in. So that's all BS, complete BS. It's your choice, it's your decision, and that, you know, the media love to take something like that and run with it. And it's not the world of wrestling drove them to alcohol or the world of wrestling drove them to drugs. No, you do that to yourself, all right? And anyone that says, you know, please come and debate me. Let's debate it right now. Go fact for fact. You know, that's your choice.
So it was Guerrero's choice.
Yes, definitely.
But you had sympathy for him.
Yeah.
Right? You understood you understood why he popped those pills.
I understood why. I didn't understand, you know, I couldn't understand like how they could control you so much in the way that they did him. But I understood why. Yeah, we're in pain.
He's back and healthy now, right?
Yeah. Yeah, completely. Yeah. As I said, he's the most influential person that I've ever met in my life. Like, inspiring.
The wrestling world in shock today. Former champion Chris Benoit found dead in his Atlanta home along with his wife and young son. Police now treating the discovery as a double murder-suicide. World Wrestling Entertainment says Benoit failed to show for 2 live events over the weekend, and apparently at least 1 suspicious text message sent to friends prompted wrestling officials to send police to his house. On the phone now, staff writer for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, Saeed Ahmed. And Saeed, what do you know about this suspicious text message?
Well, the sheriff's department will only confirm that he sent at least 1 text message sometime around 4:30 a.m. Saturday. And I know that the WWE is saying that he sent several others, which is what prompted them to contact the sheriff's office to go do a welfare check at the house. But the other thing that they are saying now is that he allegedly killed the wife and child sometime over the weekend and then took his life on Monday.
At his home, with the dead bodies of his wife and later his son nearby, WWE star Chris Benoit communicated at least 12 times with co-workers. Details of phone conversations, voicemails, and text messages were released by World Wrestling Entertainment. Around 3:30 Saturday afternoon, Benoit told a co-worker by phone that he overslept and would be late to that night's WWE event in Beaumont, Texas. The co-worker, who the WWE did not name, said Benoit stated, "I love you," and sounded groggy. Minutes later, another phone conversation. Benoit's story changed. Now, he said his wife and son were sick with food poisoning. Around 4:30, another co-worker called Benoit to check in. The wrestler said his wife was throwing up blood. But by this time, authorities say, Nancy Benoit was dead, strangled by her husband some 24 hours earlier. There were 3 more phone calls between Benoit and WWE's talent relations department. The company says a representative told the wrestler to skip the Beaumont event and catch up with the tour in Houston on Sunday. About 9 hours later, just before 4 a.m. on Sunday morning, Benoit sent a series of text messages to the same co-workers he spoke with by phone. 4 of the messages listed only Benoit's home address. A 5th read, "The dogs are in the enclosed pool area. Garage side door is open."
And And we always get on the phone and, you know, and coordinate. What time you get in,
yeah,
the whole deal, I'll pick you up or he'll pick me up, whatever. So I call him, no answer. Then all of a sudden I get a call from him. And he's like, oh, call right back. Hey, Chavo, hey, what's up, man? He sounds just off. I'm like, man, you okay? He's like, yeah, I'm cool, man. Just really bad. A really, really just bad weekend. And just, you know, Daniel and Nancy are sick, his wife, you know, and, you know.
So you're actually talking to him at this point.
I'm talking to him, yeah. And he's
and this is basically after he's probably killed his wife.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. They're sick, you know, they're not feeling good. And I'm like, all right, cool. And, well, you coming in? Yeah, I missed my flight. But don't worry, I'm going to catch another flight and I'll be there. Okay, I could just call me when you get in and I'll pick you up, you know, no matter what time it is. You know, we were landing in Houston. I had to drive to Belmont. And I was like, you know, don't worry about it. We're late. I'll wait for you. Okay. So he gets off getting ready to get off the phone. And he goes, he makes a point. It stops. He goes, Chavo. I go, yeah. And he goes, I love you. I said, I love you too, man. Wasn't too odd, you know, off kilter, because mm-hmm. we always tell each other we love each other.
Yeah.
But this was really forced. It was not forced. It was really like made a point of it. It was like, hey, man, okay, I love you, brother. Okay, no, it was like, Chavo, I love you.
I want you to understand this.
Basically, mm-hmm. yeah, if you
don't forget this,
coming from a man with very few words.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, all right, I love you too, bro. So I hung up, and I thought that was strange. So I called him right back. And I go, hey, man, are you all right? I'm fine, man. Like I said, I just had a real hard weekend, you know, and just, you know, real hard weekend. And I had to go take him, you know, Daniel and Nancy to the hospital. And I'm like, oh, okay, man. Well, I'm here. Okay, man. Okay, cool. So then hung up. And that was the last I actually talked to him. I guess he called Scott Armstrong, too. He and I hooked up. Scotty, we hooked up and we ended up driving, waiting for Chris. No call. I'm calling, hey, dude, did you miss your flight? Did you make your new flight? No call, no answer. Okay, well, I guess we got to drive. Well, if we got to come back, you know, we said if we got to come back from and go pick him up, we will. So we went to the show, and, you know, the agents were asking, where's Chris?
This is a house show.
House show. Where's Chris? Chris. Next day was a pay-per-view,
yeah.
In Houston. Well, I'm like, I don't know, man. I don't know. He missed his flight, you know, he's going to, okay. So we drive to Houston the next day, me and Scotty. And
still no word.
Still no from Chris. We're calling him, getting nothing. I get some texts on my phone at probably 5 a.m. And I get a text from Chris.
So you wake up in the morning, you've got
not even texts. Before. It woke me up before, oh, okay, 5 in the morning. So I look at the my text and I'm like, that's weird. It says the dogs are in the enclosed pool area. The garage door is open. I looked at it. I was like, well, that's weird. Is this one of those texts you get? You know, sometimes you get texts, you know, from 3 days ago. You never
get texts, you know, from 3 days ago. You never
delivered, yeah, and then all of a sudden you got a text. And this is kind of the start of texting. You know, now it's a little different, but
yeah,
back
it was
then,
2007.
A lot of times, you know, texts didn't come through and they got lost, and all of a sudden you got them. And I was like, well, that's weird.
Half a text.
Yeah, that was weird. So okay, I wrote it off. Then I get another text from Nancy's phone, from his wife's phone, and it said the same thing. You know, the same text. That's really weird. Okay, whatever. I kind of wrote it off. So then I had to get up in 2 hours. So I got up. I look at – I go downstairs to meet Scotty Armstrong. And I look at him. I go, did you get some weird – anything weird last night happen? And he goes, yeah, I got some weird text from Chris. I said, me too. Did it say this? He goes, yeah. So we call Chris. No answer. So we go to the pay-per-view. Chris isn't showing up. And they're asking us, where's he at? I'm not sure. We're not sure where he's at. Now we're covering for him. We think maybe, you know.
Blatantly lying for him now.
Well, yeah. We're blatantly, you know, whatever. We're just covering for him. No, I haven't heard from him. I don't know what's going on. Okay, great. Didn't tell us anything about the text, nothing.
Did you feel something was going on weird
something,
at this point?
Something was going on. And I remember Arn Anderson saying, this is later on in the day, because he was supposed to wrestle the pay-per-view.
He was supposed to wrestle for the title.
The ECW Championship against CM Punk.
of a suicide note or somebody that can say, he actually talked to me, that was his voice, and he said he killed his wife and son. So far, I would be very suspicious that we don't have another party involved in this crime, and I'm not sure Chris Benoit even committed suicide. I would need, as an investigator, something in his own hand that I could absolutely compare, or something in his own voice that a voice print could actually be established. Because absent of that, an instant message in or an email could have been written by anybody.
But here's my concern. Number one, why is it we're assuming that he committed suicide? I haven't seen a suicide note. I haven't heard anything about the fact that he had 3 days from the time he killed his wife.
Think somebody else hung him?
Wait a minute. From the time he killed his wife and his son, he had 2 days to write a note or write something. Who is this person who announces on Wikipedia? That she is dead 12 hours before
law enforcement
finds her.
That's the big question for me.
Who, and think about it, Sean. Right. This is Wikipedia, and where that person sent it from is Stamford, Connecticut, which is the headquarters of WWE. Third thing, why is it that WWE, within 2 seconds of the finding of these three bodies, said, it's not us, it's not us? You know, it's almost as though they protested too much.
Ken, you want to weigh in? Go ahead.
Yeah, the thing about the Wikipedia thing, the person who did that came forward on it. When he didn't show up at the pay-per-view that night...
Yeah, but it doesn't explain it. Don't you think that's a little suspicious, 12 hours before...
But if you'll let me finish, what came out on the thing was the guy was on a message chat board. They said, "Hey, Benoit, didn't happen." And the guy, just being a smart aleck, went on and he happened to say something, just stirring the pot.
Wait, it turned out
to be right.
How many people say something to stir the pot that a woman is dead when in truth she is? I don't believe in coincidences.
If you said she was sick
and she didn't and he didn't show up because she was sick, that's one thing. But to say that she's dead and to be right is too
crazy. Let me, Kimberly, your thoughts on that.
That
is beyond suspicious for anybody.
I think it's very suspicious on him.
You know why you're here, why we asked you to come down.
Yeah.
Okay. Why don't you tell me?
All right, Alex. All right.
First, are you a wrestling fan?
Yeah.
Okay. A big one?
Yeah, well, pretty big.
Okay. Go on.
Okay. Well, over like last weekend, the wrestler Benoit, there was rumors going on because he missed the pay-per-view and his scheduled dates, which he never does. Mm-hmm. And I was reading rumors and speculation online.
Where online?
On forums. I forgot the exact sites. But I was like,
okay, hold on. On forums?
Yeah.
Okay. In any chat rooms?
No, not chat rooms. I was just reading about it, and some rumors came up, and I just...
Yeah, what were the rumors?
That his family was sick, or someone maybe died, like his wife perhaps, because he missed the pay-per-view.
Okay. And when was that?
Sunday.
Around what time Sunday, roughly?
It was at night. Maybe between 10 and 12-ish before the post.
Okay. Where's this computer that you were using?
My laptop. Oh, it's at home.
It's at home. I'm going to ask for a consent for it to search. All right?
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Okay. It won't hurt the computer. It's just a forensic examination to... Because what they really want to do is find out where these rumors started, okay?
I'm not sure if they're still up or not. They could have.
Well, they can. As long as you were in it and you looked at it, they can check, okay?
Okay.
So, what type of computer do you have?
A Dell Inspiron.
Okay. Okay, so you saw these rumors. You're not sure exactly what sites, but it was in forums?
I believe so.
Okay.
Mostly I kind of added fuel to the fire. It was really more of my own speculation.
Okay. And what was your speculation?
I just thought that his wife may have died or...
Okay. And you speculate on how?
Nah, I can't. It was wrong. I just because I saw he never misses a date.
Okay. But did you speculate on how she died?
No.
No.
Just that she was dead.
Just that she was dead.
Yeah, nothing about murders or anything.
Okay. All right, go on.
Yeah, so I was just on Wikipedia and I just made the post. Because like a lot of people like on Wikipedia make, you know, like unsourced like posts and stuff. Mm-hmm. Like it happens like all the time.
Yeah.
So this was just like, I just assumed, I can't really explain why I did it. It was just stupid. But I did, and I assumed Wikipedia would just delete it like instantly, since it wasn't like, it wasn't sourced or anything. Never did I expect that to actually be the case, you know, the next night when I got home from work, you know, when I heard about the whole mm-hmm. murder situation.
I'm sick of you ducking me, Undertaker! You know I'm the most dominant superstar in SmackDown, and you know you can't prove me wrong!
You think I'm afraid of you, little man? I can't count the number of superstars who have tested themselves against the dead man and come up short. If you insist on making this mistake, then your grieving family will have no one to blame but you when the inevitable occurs. If you insist on making this mistake, then your grieving family will have no one to blame but you when the inevitable occurs.
Alright y'all, in this part of the video I felt I had to come in so I can basically explain this connection a little bit better than typing it. Just so y'all could get my perspective and making this connection with them saying that Bibles were placed beside the bodies inside of the home where Chris supposedly killed his wife and son. Now, if y'all remember the videos, the previous sacrifice videos I've done, we can make this connection, and this basically gives us, you know, more proof that the occult was behind the murders of the Benoit family. So in the Pimp C sacrifice video, his body was found in praying position when, you know, they found his body in the hotel or whatever. Mac Miller was also found in praying position. Capital Steez, they say he jumped off the building holding a Bible. So that gives us three deaths, three sacrifices that had something to do with the Bible, or just, you know, religion, or them basically, you know, mocking God when they do these sacrifices. You know, like, that's when I actually saw that they said Chris Benoit placed Bibles around the bodies, I was like, all right, that's it right there. You know, really, that's all the proof I needed, because I remember this situation when it happened, but I never went deep into the Chris Benoit rabbit hole myself. So this was, a lot of this information was new to me, you know. But when I saw this, besides all the numbers that I seen, besides his death date numbers and stuff, you know, This just was the nail in the coffin right here. This is obvious that the occult was behind this, because this is what they do. This is how they mock the sun. This is what they do. You know, it's no coincidence that we have, you know, that we can make a connection to other sacrifice videos that I've done where bodies were found in praying position, or, you know, the celebrity or whoever it was, they died with a Bible next to them or something. You know what I'm saying? This is patterns that we can't ignore. You know, and we're just now finding this out, because a lot of us are just now coming to the information and starting to realize and notice how the occult works with these sacrifices. You know, so for me, like I said, that was like the nail in the coffin and showing that, you know, this was a sacrifice. The Benoit family was murdered. Chris Benoit did not kill his wife nor his son. And that's just that, you know. So there's really not much more for me to basically convince you of that. But the video's not over. I do have a couple more clips, and y'all know I'll come back in and just kind of wrap up everything about the entire video. So with that being said, check out these last clips, and I'm gonna talk to y'all soon.
I knew Chris Benoit a long time before that. I made three trips with Chris. See, Chris trained in Japan, and I made three trips over there with him. The first trip, he was green, and I guess they were training him or whatever. And then the next trips, I was over there. He was over there. He was already over there. Oh, man, what a talent. What a talent. Good gravy. He was accused of killing woman and his son. My opinion, I will give you my opinion of Chris Benoit. That was his son with woman.
Yes.
See, I was with woman when woman was with Kevin Sullivan in Florida. Kevin Sullivan broke woman in the business in Florida, in the Florida territory. I know woman. Okay, I do not believe for one iota that Chris Benoit killed his son and killed woman. I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all. I believe that maybe Chris Benoit found them, and because his son was dead and he done himself, he committed suicide. It's just so hard. It's so hard for me to comprehend Chris doing anything like that. But see, that it don't make no sense. Other than he seen them, he found them, and I don't know what were they. You know what? Get your kid, man. What would you? Why was your kid involved in it? That's what, you know.
Y'all, so this is my take on the entire, you know, Chris Benoit family supposed murder suicide, right? And I'm not gonna make this too long because, you know, I in my research of just looking up every theory that people came up with around, you know, the murders, I come to find out that, you know, this is like, well, I'll say it by saying that when people, you know, go so hard at something to find out the truth about it, like they come up with 30 different theories about what could have possibly happened, that lets you know that the devil was in the details. And I've talked about this before on the channel, and by now y'all know that confusion equals the devil and the occult. God is not confusion. God is the truth, and God is like, you know, that's it. That's it's this, you know, divine final answer. That's it. You know, it's God. He doesn't confuse you. He sends you down a rightful, truthful path, you know, so you know what's going on when God is in the details. When the devil is in the details, you don't know what the fuck is going on. So you're constantly guessing. You're constantly coming up with, you know, a theory about what this could have possibly been. That lets you know, for everybody that's kind of like on the fence about this Chris Benoit thing, that lets you know that the occult was behind it. You know, like, people, you know, doing my research, people were answering their own questions just by, you know, questioning the fact that something was off about this entire case. But, you know, they're like, I don't know. I think
it was this. He may have really killed himself. I don't know. It could have been a murder. It's like, all right, look, just calm down and think for a second. That's what a lot of people get wrong when we're going down these rabbit holes. You know, the confusion will like take your mind and it will force you to keep searching for something that's already in the details. Like it's already there. You already know the truth about it, but you keep going, you keep pushing it, you know, because you can't like, you can't put a finger on it. You just think you know it. So you want something that you could see that's like gonna be that like definite, like, oh yeah, I knew it. But when truthfully, you're never gonna find that. You're never gonna find it because the cult was behind it. This is like, it's like a tactic. You know, they do certain things to confuse you and harvest your energy. That's what this is about. And y'all gotta understand that. This is about harvesting energy around the sacrifices. It's a sort of magic. And this is what they do. This case is just like many others, where it's so much confusion to get to the truth. You don't know what the hell is going on. It was done that way on purpose. You know, like XXX, Michael Jackson. So many sacrifices were done this way to just cause havoc, cause confusion, harvest your energy. You know, even this has nothing to do with this case, but even that Kanika Jenkins case, everything was done to confuse you. You know how much, like, do you know how much the demons ate off of people's energy and people giving their like entire day to solving a mystery that was really right in front of your face? It didn't need, you know, it didn't need anything further. You already knew the truth, you know, but people were so caught up in actually wanting to find that, you know, that just direct perfect answer to solve the case that they just kept going. It's the same way with the Chris Benoit thing that I see people do on YouTube. You know, there's a few channels dedicated to just researching and doing things about that case when you don't need to do all of that. You already know what happened. You know, you're just looking for it to finalize it in your head. But truthfully, like I said, you're never going to find it. A lot of these sacrifices, you're not meant to know the truth, not meant to know the gritty of what actually happened. That's not, you know, it wasn't done in that way for you to ever know that. You see what I'm saying? And that's what I try to explain to people on this channel when we do these type of videos and when we're like, you know, because I don't have all the answers. I'm not speaking that my say is just the final say, but I'm trying to give you another perspective so you can actually sit back and be like, okay, yeah, the occult was definitely behind this murder. I don't even need to go any deeper in it because I'm not going to find what I'm actually looking for. But at least I know, you know, who was behind this shit, because we see the patterns. We're starting to understand, you know, how they do these sacrifices. So we know what's going on. So you know, we don't have to go, you know, deep trying to find just the smallest details to, you know, reassure us of what we're thinking, you know, that happened. You know, so we spiritually, we got to be aware that the devil causes confusions. If we don't understand that concept, then we don't understand what we're looking at and what we're trying to find out. You know, as soon as you start questioning some shit, as soon as you like, nah, this don't add up, why would he send this text message? You know, what about the Kevin Sutherland dude, Sullivan? What about this? What about that? You know what I'm saying? Who was at his door when he was on the phone? Blah, blah, blah. Like, once you find yourself questioning all that, then you have your answer. You have your answer. It's not what you think, and it's definitely not what the media told you. It's nothing but confusion. You know what I'm saying? So I wanted to get on here, you know, and not just go too long. I just wanted to, you know, just kind of like stretch that, you know, and like really just kind of like beat it in y'all head. You know what I'm saying? just to notice when things are, you know, off, like, you know, that's your spirit confirming to you what actually happened, you know, and you got to start listening to that more and stop looking for shit, you know, in comments or looking for other theories. Believe in what your spirit is telling you. That really is all that matters. You see what I'm saying? So even, you know, even off of what, you know, I believe or whatever, you may not believe what I believe, but that's okay, because that's gonna sit in your spirit and make you feel better at the end of the day. You see what I'm saying? So to just wrap it all up, man, we'll never know the truth. We will never know the complete truth about the situation, but I can definitely 100% tell y'all that the cult was behind it. And it did not happen the way that the media told us. That teenager, he did not post that to Wikipedia. It just doesn't make sense. He wasn't even scared in the interview. You could tell this was like a rehearse. Usually a kid being involved in something like that at a young age, they're fucking terrified. You know, that you could have had something to do with a murder or you're involved in this crazy, you know, situation. You know, he just seemed a little bit too rehearsed and calm for me, you know? So I don't want to just sit here and go into every single detail about it and just continue to drag it on, because that's not what I like to do. I like to kind of just focus it around, you know, one point of the entire mystery and just attack that, you know, and show y'all that, you know, like I said, the occult is behind the sacrifice, and, you know, Vince McMahon and WWE, you know, these sacrifices take place in every industry, you know, no matter what it is, you know, no matter what sport it is, they happen and they take place. That's why we got, you know, a few clips and a few things that kind of foreshadowed his death, you know, and they were running a Vince McMahon dies segment around the time that Chris Benoit died. And then they canceled it because Chris Benoit actually died in real life. So that lets you know, like, what's the coincidence of y'all running this kind of segment and then someone, a huge superstar, actually ends up dying for real in real life? There's no coincidence in that. You know, there's no coincidence in that, bro. So yeah, man, it's been another one. Chris Benoit, you know, family sacrifice. You know, I don't really know how I would word this one, you know, but y'all already know, man. Y'all know what's going on, man. It's Sunday sacrifice. So I hope y'all having a good day, man. I hope y'all having a blessed day. You know, relax, get some things done, whatever the case may be. And yeah, man, y'all already know what's going on. I'll be back in a day or two with another video, talk to y'all about a few different things. It's Black Balloon, and I'm gonna see y'all soon.